Say what goes around comes around, and that is certainly true for one particular lady from Orchard Park. When times were tough, she needed a helping hand. And then when times got better, she decided to pay it forward. Here's 7 Eyewitness News reporter Justin Moore.
I didn't have a choice.
After spending 8 months in a Buffalo shelter, Jillian James is now back on her feet working.
But I had pretty much a lot, and it all just kind of fell out. You know, the rug fell out under me.
The Orchard Park woman says she was forced to leave everything behind to escape an abusive husband.
You don't know when it's going to happen to you. I mean, you don't plan for it.
The shelter she was living in was one of the organizations that receives food donations from the Food Bank of Western New York.
And then when I found out it was the food bank, I thought, this is amazing. Like, how come nobody knows that?
Before then, like many people, James' perspective about food banks wasn't so positive.
When they hear food bank, I think they're thinking more of the people that are like on the street and that kind of thing. They're not thinking of people just like me. I mean, I lived in Orchard Park.
She knew once she was back on her feet, she wanted to pay it forward. She's doing just that.
Because I didn't have anything. And if it wasn't for the fact that it was the food bank, then I wouldn't be where I am right now.
James spends a lot of her time helping the Food Bank of Western New York. In fact, she's giving a speech tomorrow morning at the annual Walk of Hunger in Williamsville.
We like to say that there is no one face of hunger.
Catherine Schick with the Food Bank of Western New York says it feeds more than 140,000 meals a month. That's why it's important for people like James to share their stories.
To really truly humble yourself is to give back. And it doesn't have to be money, and it can just be your time.
And Lackawanna, Justin Moore, 7 Eyewitness News.